justices, distinguished vice chancellors, deans, principals of law colleges, Mr. Manohar Kairani and his very hard-working team of teachers, staff and students, eminent voters assembled here, ladies and gentlemen. We have just heard from Professor Shivakumar and Venkatramani as to how this initiative of the voting competition for the law students from SAARC countries started about 3 years ago have grown to this level where it encompasses not only the voting competition but also a students' conference on a legal topic, now a judicial colloquium on teaching ethics to the professions of lawyers and judges, and also some publications of students. Papers presented at the law conference are now being published, a standard publication which, as Shivakumar said, going to be released later in the day. Now this amazing transformation in legal education with so much of hard work, which according to Shivakumar is almost 6 months, starting in August and ending in February. It's amazing to learn as to how Mr. Manohar Kairani and his team could mobilize so many judges, so many lawyers, law teachers, law students from all over the place for this third edition of the competition and its sister event, the Law Students Conference. Let me pay my tribute to this organizational abilities of this team and their commitment to the cause of better legal education in the South Asian region. Mentioning about South Asian region, now India under the present Prime Minister is almost looking globally and particularly to the East, and today we have started talking in terms of ASEAN countries, countries of the entire Asian continent. And we are told that 21st century is the continent of Asia. And we are told during the course of this century, very big organizational changes in power structure in the global scenario is going to happen, apart from economic and technological developments. And in this change scenario, Asia is going to occupy the most significant leading space, and we are all waiting. And in that transformed phase where we will have a world of so much of diversities, so much of differences, but living peacefully under rule of law, where lawyers are going to take a very important role in managing this transformation. You must think big. You must be able to visualize the state of affairs, and you must be able to see as to how your profession is going to contribute in a significant way to get the 21st century under the leadership of Asia is going to reflect the future of the world and the future destiny of mankind. I therefore say that probably the organization team might look for its if not the fourth edition, the fifth edition of the competitions in terms of ASEAN countries rather than limiting to SAARC countries. It is said that we learned cricket from the Britishers and the Australians, and very soon we have outsmarted them in cricket. Similarly, we have learned mooting from the Britishers, their legal system, from the Americans, and we seem to be outsmarting the Britishers and the Americans even in mooting. Because I find that teams which go from particularly India to different international competitions in Washington DC and elsewhere are coming away with the trophies, beating established universities like Harvard and Stanford and whatever. So therefore, this is a game which India is playing successfully to establish their leadership in the 21st century in the intellectual world. No doubt, voting did help a great deal in improving the standards of legal education. I say this because I know in this country there are over a dozen national level voting competitions, and hundreds of law students from countries which are not in the grade 1 or grade 2 but grade 3 students are coming and are enthusiastically participating in these 12 or 15 different national competitions. Now therefore there is a definitive change in the average standard of legal education, and the law students have started looking at law and its role in a changing world. Students who have never looked or fully read a judgment during their entire 5-year career seem to be now reading judgments, because without reading the judgment in full and analyzing it, you can't prepare for a moot court competition. So they are forced to read judgments, analyze it, how to find out the ratio of the case, how to distinguish it from similar cases, and then they have to prepare the pleadings for submission of the written brief, and then the advocacy in the actual court. So this exercise has transformed the educational career of even average students who otherwise would have written a law examination focusing only on the examination, not acquiring knowledge or skills. So therefore this is the way moot court has helped. But it seems to me that we are overdoing the mooting aspect of legal learning to the exclusion of other skills which are equally or perhaps more importantly needed. After all, in the mooting process, you are not acquiring all the skills that are necessary for a trial court lawyer, where you are to face with fact gathering, you have to shift the evidence, you have to identify the issues, you have to prove those facts with admissible and relevant evidence in a court of law, how to extract through examination chief, cross-examination and re-examination what the trial court demands to establish the facts and apply the law. So therefore, overdoing of mooting, which may help in the appellate courts or in a constitutional court, it does help the trial court also, but more substantially, there are certain skill sets which are required for a trial lawyer that is missing. I don't know, some law schools do have mock trials also, which require much elaborate preparation. But are we preparing the future mediators? Are we preparing the future arbitrators? We are told that the alternative system, dispute resolution system, is going to be brought into the mainstream and litigation is going to be reduced because it is too expensive and dilatory, which poor countries cannot afford. We have 3 crore cases pending. How long? And people say it will take another 300 years to be able to clear the backlog. What type of justice is that? So therefore, the future lawyers will have to less and less emphasize on litigation, adjudication aspects, and more on settlement, on public policy development, on legislative drafting, on the various aspects of governance through rule of law at various national, state and local levels. So if we consider the importance of other skills which are necessary to be developed, and more importantly the ethics part of it, then I would argue that out of 5 years to get a law degree, at least 1/3 of that period, maybe a year and a half, should be exclusively available for practice learning, experiential learning, learning of skills. How is the law curriculum going to be organized? Lawyering is a bundle of skills. It is not knowledge of all the laws. Nobody can ever have knowledge of all the laws. How those skills, soft skills as well as hard skills, and the professional skills, and the right attitude, and the ethics, how can these be internalized during the student days is a big challenge for those legal educators who are looking to the future. So therefore, moot court can continue, but it's going to be a very small aspect of legal learning, legal research, legal writing, and advocacy through mediation, conciliation, and the rest will have to be developed in years to come, which perhaps the organizers of this event will have to think about. I just only want to say one more thing before I sit down. I believe that the average law student who is not fortunate enough to join one of the prestigious national law schools or any other private law schools, there are increasing number of them in our country. Those average students who come from an average law school where the teaching is relatively poor, where skills training is almost absent, and they are also passing the examination and coming and enrolling themselves as advocates. They are also wanting to earn a decent life by being a justice provider in the system, maybe in their communities, in rural and tribal areas. But without competence, how are you going to service the justice needs of the people, even if you do not want to go in corporate? Can you please, So therefore, I'm just wondering that something which I am presently involved, I must share it with you. I am involved in what is called continuing legal education. This is something new in our country and perhaps in other countries of the South Asian region. But it's very important in Western countries which have developed legal systems. I understand in many jurisdictions in America, you can't be a lawyer unless you revive your license every year after getting a certain number of credits of continuing education, either from a law school or from any other agency which offer that. I'm told, Justice Peiris, former Chief Justice of Sri Lanka, was telling me that even today in America, Britain and Australia and New Zealand, if you want to practice matrimonial cases, you have to have a special license for that. An ordinary advocate cannot just jump into from the criminal court to the family court and start arguing on matrimonial matters. A special license after a proper training is what is required to accredit a lawyer as a lawyer in matrimonial disputes. I think the Family Courts Act prescribes qualification for the judge of the family court, but not for the lawyer. What the Family Courts Act was adopted was, keep the lawyers out. That is not the right strategy. We should have lawyers, but properly trained and accredited, who will be specializing in that area. That should come. Similarly, commercial courts. You can't just jump from one court to the other in commercial matters unless you read the developments that are happening almost on a daily basis. So specialization is required. Law schools cannot give specialization when they prepare the undergraduate lawyer. So that can come on continuing legal education. So therefore, the Kerala Bar Council 3 years ago have set up an academy supported by our Attorney General for continuing education. And I happen to hold a charge of the activities of that academy. We design courses according to the needs of the young lawyer, the new entrant to the profession. And thrust is on skills, thrust is on ethics, thrust is on the right attitude. How do you organize it? Not through lectures. It has to be a participatory program. It has to be residential also. So we organize 3-day residential courses now under the Kerala Bar Council Academy for Continuing Legal Education. From this year onwards, that is 2018-19, we are opening up. Usually it is only for new entrants to the, already you have enrolled advocate, you are given this program. But from this year, we are allowing the final year students, LLB 5th year students, who want to take to the legal profession, can also apply and join these courses. And I have a list of courses which are available. Here is the registrar of the academy. Why don't you identify? His name is Dr. V.S. G.G. Mohan. He has a list of courses. The first course which is going to happen next month is going to be on criminal trial advocacy. Thereafter, we have a course on for 3 days on evidentiary issues for a trial court lawyer. Then we have on civil practice on trial courts. And then we have on mediation, only on mediation. Mediation, negotiation, mediation, how to become a mediator. And then on arbitration. So similar courses which are not available in an average law school. And people who want to prepare themselves for the future directions of the profession, this Institute of Continuing Legal Education is offering. And we will be too happy to have the fifth year law students from the SAARC countries, if they want to be participant in some of these courses of their choice, we welcome them. And it is happening in a city called Kochi, the southernmost state of Kerala, the port city of Kochi, which is attractive in many ways and which the capital of New Delhi cannot offer. So therefore, if you are wanting to expand, you know, your knowledge, your experience of this country, etc., I welcome you. The course is limited only for 30 participants, nobody more. So therefore, it is very selective and very modest registration is there. The details will be given by, we have a printed outline. Those of you who want to have it, collect it from him. Let me wish all the best to the young competitors who are ready to start the mounting display soon after this inaugural function. Thank you.